This is me, Ddj-Rr Nkume. In today's video, I'll be doing a review of Ddj-Rr, as you can see. So today I'll be showing you the functions and the review, how it functions. So if this time is your first time watching my YouTube channel or you're following me, please do subscribe and give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to share to your friends. And also, if you are dreaming to become a DJ and you want to become a well-known DJ like me, you have to follow me up, subscribe to my YouTube channel, because from today on, I'll be dropping videos giving you more tips on how to become a DJ and how to use your machines apart from the software. So I'll be introducing so many things to you today with this particular machine. If you watch my previous video on this YouTube channel, you'll find out that I did a video where I explained about my first control, which is Ddj-Sb2, and now I've upgraded to Ddj-Rr. Okay, so stay tuned and watch me how I will explain the whole functions from key one, from one another, just from one by one, that's bit by bit. I will explain how it functions, how you can also use it to create your own beat if you want to use this particular machine to create your own beat. So just stay tuned and let me teach you the things, the basic things you need to know about controller, especially this Ddj-Rr. Okay, let's go. First of all, now I've already on my PC, and this is the application. This is how it look like, the software that functions with this machine. So I've already on it, though I didn't start video on time when I on the machine, but all I have to do, I have to on the machine right there when I for you to see how it looks like when it's been on, because now it is off. So now this power button, as you can see, and now on it, you see it's not on, it's still synchronized, it's still booting on. So after this, now you see it's not ready, it's not on. So now I have to explain this this machine to you now. So as you can see, this is the jog wheel, they call it jog wheel for scratching, if you want to scratch. And this this light, LCD light here, shows you when your track is playing and when it's about to finish. Okay, so even if you're not looking at your computer, at your PC right here, and you're playing, once the light start blinking here, you know that the track is about to finish. Then you can change into another track. And here, looking at here, you can see this reverse. Okay, if you're playing and you want to reverse back to the beginning, or you want to go a little bit back, you can press this button. It will take you to reverse, to reverse the track that is playing. If you want to adjust the speed a little bit, you can use this. You can see 1x2. Okay, you can adjust front and back. Okay, and this is the effect buttons, effect selected buttons. Okay, so you can change your sound to maybe. The next video I'll be doing, I'll be playing a music with it, so I'll be showing you how to use the buttons to change your music sound or tune. And here is the tempo. As you can see, you can increase your tempo from one level to another through this button. Okay, and as you can see, this is the load button. When you search your music, as you can see, I'm using this one to search music now. See this button now, you watch my PC is searching the music. Okay, then once you search the music from here, then you see this load, then you go to load, you press load. As I press load now, see the music have already load, then you see it's ready to play. Like I told you, this is a jog wheel. Okay, as you can see, it's moving on the PC. This is the jog wheel. Then this is the cue point. If you want to cue it from the point, maybe next video I'll be showing how to cue. Then this is synchronize, and this is a shift button. Okay, the function of this shift button is, for instance, let's say I cue this music here with this Q1, this Q1 here, and I don't like it and I want to remove it. As you can see, the light is showing to show that it's cued, and I don't like it, I want to remove it. You can press this shift. As you press the shift, then you press it. Easy, it's off, the light is no more there. If I want to put it back, I put it back. See, the light is showing now. Then if I want to remove it, I use the shift key and I remove it. So this is the recording. If you want to create your own beat on your own self, this is the recording. Okay, you can record it, then after recording you press capture. Okay, to capture what you have just recorded, then you can play, which is start. what you have recorded, and this is the sequence, as in to load it in sequence, so you can be able to store it there. So whenever you want to play from this sequence, okay, this is the loop in loop out, where you can reduce your beats either from 4 or 8 or 16 or 32 to be repeating. They call it repeating button, but in DJ stuff we call it beat loop, to loop at beat, okay. And this is how to increase it, whether you want it to be 4 or 8 or 16, or as you can see the beat. Then here is also if you want to jump from 4 beats to 8 bit or 16 bit or 32 bit, you can do it in and out. As I've already selected it here, if you want to loop it in again, you can click the two or in the depending on the one you want to leave it, either in 4, 16 or 32, depending on the beat you're playing, you want to do it. So I have explained this part, and also this is the tempo master tempo button to rearrange the tempo back to its original point. If you don't want to use, if you are gone beyond what and the music is so fast, you want to, you don't want to start regulating here, you can use this master tempo range just to bring it back to the normal tempo. And this is a 4-deck machine. I forget to say that this is a 4-deck machine. You can use it in 4 different channels, okay. This one I'm using now is channel 3, is what I'm using now, because they built channel 1 and channel 2 and channel 3 the same place. So as you can, let me change to channel 1 now. You see that the light will change to show that the particular deck you're using, okay. You see the light is now blue, as you can see, which means I'm using deck 1 now. Then if I put it back in deck 3, then showing me white to show I'm in deck 3. And there's something else I love so much about this Ddj-Rr, because you can even use your phone. If you don't have your laptop, you can use your iPad in form of laptop, then you set it to here. You see the light is off, okay. The light is little bit on, but it's fainting. As you can see, three lights showing you now that is on your phone. You can use your iPad, you can use your normal phone to do this. Then if you have your laptop like I do, and see when it's on our phone level, it show this way, it show it this way, everything is still working. We'll look at it, it's still functioning normal, okay. Then if I'm using, in case I'm using my iPad to play, I don't want to use my laptop to play, I want to use my iPad, then I use this. Then in case I want to go back to, I have my laptop, as you can see, I'll switch it over back to 3, okay, or deck 1, whichever I want. I just put it on that 3, okay, for you to understand. Then coming back here, this is the back to go to the track. See, they say back to the track or tag track, as in you want to have a tag, you just want to remember that track to be playing there, so you can be able to, you don't have time to be searching for it or looking for it again. Once you press here, it will bring out the particular track instantly. So don't worry, in my next video I'll be explaining how to use all this thing, but I'm just telling you the functions. This one is the master volume, and this is the boot volume, okay. This boot monitor to show if the sound is going out of hand, is making noise. This boot can help you to regulate your sound. And this is the earphone, where you can hear the sound in your ear before mixing it out, okay. And this is the effect, the sound effect, the samples. You can be able to create your own effect while playing song, can put, you know, those sound like DJ, just to mention your name, you load it here. And this filter to change also your sound of your tune, some tune of the music. This filter, this is the bass, and this is the mid, and this is the treble, and this is the main G, the main volume for this line. It's called 10, but the in mixer you get it, they call it gain, okay. And it's exactly the same thing here. I explained the other side, it's just the same thing here. And this is the Q volume, this is the play, okay. Now you can see you have different lights here, but sorry, the light of my camera cannot be able to allow you to see the different color of light, but at least you can see a little bit. This is the effect pad effects one, and now this is the Q point, like I said before. This is silence, direct to select a particular point you want to be repeating, okay. And this is the sampler, where you can be able to, you know, change the name of the effect you want to, either you want to put your name or want to put another thing. So in this video, as you can see the back here, you see where to plug your audio cord, and this is where you can plug the iPad 1 or iPad 2, depending on how many iPad want to use on this. And this is the microphone servo on the microphone level, and these are the cord that connects to your PC, and this is the power cord. And if you come back to here, you see here's the volume of the earpiece. Either if I have 2 ports of earpiece, either use the big earpiece or use the small one, depending on the one you have. and this is the mic volume here to increase or reduce the volume. So this is a Pioneer DJ and it's a record box compatible. Okay, so here I'm gonna draw it for a close for here today. Just all you have to do is for you to subscribe this channel and also make sure you follow me up every day and always check on me and make sure you turn your notification bell on so that anytime I upload new video you can be able to get it first and watch. So if you are dreaming to become a DJ, I think here is the right place, this is the right channel, and this is the right person you need to follow up. I'll be explaining details by details. So as you can see, everything is set, but for today I'm not going to use beats. Okay, just want to explain it for in case you're going for you want to buy a DJ machine, any kind of DJ machine you want, and have any question to ask me, just drop your comments below. I'll be gladly to reply you and tell you what to do in it. Okay, before I forgot, this is a panel. This panel represents, if you want to check all the systems in this particular, this Ddj-Rr, you want to check all the panel, you want to know where everything is functioning, how the settings are, you can go through this. As you can see, let me show you on my computer. Just watch, you see different things going up. You see the change as I'm pressing is bringing different kind of thing out. So that means you have to, you that way you see if everything is working fine before you start your mixing. So for now, I think I will stop for today in this video. I think I have to stop for here. I think I have to draw it for a close in this particular point. So just leave your comments below. If you love this video and you love more to hear from me, just give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Also, turn your notification bell on to get all the information I'll be dropping any moment I upload. So thank you and God bless you. And don't forget to share. This is my first video on this review of Ddj-Rr. Sorry you cannot see my face, but at least you can hear my voice. One of these days I'll show you my face there and you see that what I'm doing is real. But I just want you to concentrate first on what I'm teaching you first of all. Then the day I will make use of, I'll begin the tutorial of scratching, how to scratch with your joypad and all this thing. Then you can see my face and how I do that. Okay, love you and God bless you and remain blessed. So see you next time on my video. Don't forget to subscribe and share to your friends that are dreaming to be a DJ, and you will not regret subscribing this channel. So thank you and God bless you. Don't forget to share and give it thumbs up. Thank you. Any question or anything you want to know more about this, you can drop your question down. I'm willing and I'll be glad to reply you as soon as I got the message. So thank you so much and don't forget, like I said, subscribe and give it a thumbs up and share with your friends and family. Thanks.